everybody, it's Matthew. As you can see, the plants behind me get pretty tall. And in order to keep them off the lights, I've been trimming them down and just taking the tops of them and kind of throwing them away. But I thought instead of just throwing them out this time, I might try cloning a few. So almost a couple weeks ago, I decided, not really knowing what I was doing, I would try to clone some of the cuttings I was taking. And in here, I actually have a few of those cuttings. I have them in just a real basic humidity dome. These ones you can pick up for about $5 at a hydroponic store, or some garden centers might carry them. And then I have like just a smaller T8 bulb with a grow bulb in there as well, just over top of it, and it seems to be doing an all right job. I like these humidity domes because they're really tall, so you can grow some plants in here, or you can take taller cuttings, and they also have a couple of vents in the top of them. So I originally took 3 cuttings, and I actually had 2 of them that took roots. And you can see here, they are starting to root underneath. So I was pretty happy with the results. And this is really beneficial because instead of, say, growing a plant this size and taking 3-4 weeks, you can just take a cutting right off your plant and plop it in the rock bowl, and you're good to go. In about a week, you should have roots starting on your plant. So if you do have a plant that's producing really well, you can just take a cutting of it, put some rooting hormone on it, and put it in the rock wool. And this is really great because it should be an exact genetic replica of that plant. So if that plant produces well, chances are the cutting you take from that plant will produce just as well. So if you're interested, I'll show you some of the tools I used to take these cuttings, as well as some of the products I used to make sure they rooted. Let's take a look. Alright, so here's some of the things I used. You won't need all of these things, but I'm going to try a couple different ways of cloning this time, and we'll see how it goes. You're going to need a jar full of some clean water, some isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol. You'll need a way to cut your plant, so a nice sharp set of shears or some razor blades. You'll need something to put your cuttings in, so you can use the rock wool or you can use the peat pots and soil. You will also need your rooting hormone, and it comes in a powder, as well as they make gel ones too. And I'm just going to use a couple of small plastic vials to put the rooting hormone in, so I'm not cloning directly into the bottle. I was told you don't want to clone directly into the bottles because if you have disease, you're more likely to spread the disease of the plant, but I've seen plenty of people just clone directly into the bottle without really any problems. It's a good idea if you're going to be using a set of shears that you clean them off first and disinfect them, and that's why we have the rubbing alcohol here. So you can just put a bit onto the paper towel and wipe off the blades. When you're trying to select the clone you want to look at the number of nodes it has. This is the number of Vs or branches it's going to have. And you're going to want a couple of those in your cutting that you take. It's also a good idea to take suckers and secondary branches. They make good candidates for clones. Here, I think I have a good one coming off the side here. It's got a couple of nodes. And so it should make for a decent candidate. So with my shears or sharp razor blade, I'm just going to cut it right next to the plant, and that will give me a cutting, and I will place it in the jar filled with water just for now while I'm taking all the rest of my cuttings. So that's one. I'm going to take a few more here, and then we can get into putting the rooting hormone on them. So once you have all your cuttings, we can trim them down a little bit more, take off the unnecessary branches or unnecessary leaves that you don't want to have on your clone. So this one looks all right. I might take off just the leaf here. Make sure I cut the base of the stem at a 45 degree angle, and then I will put it into the rooting hormone. So with this one, I'm going to try the powder. I'm just going to put it in a bit. Get it on there. And then tap off the excess. I'll be putting this one in a rock wool cube that's been soaked in pH adjusted water. And this is, you can have your own kind of special mix of nutrients that you soak these cubes in, because these aren't seedlings, these are actual cuttings, but I'll just use straight water for now, the rooting hormone, and once the roots develop on the bottom, then I'll start adding a little bit of nutrient to the cube. I'll be putting it in the cube, but not directly in the center because it's a little loose in there, so I'll just be offsetting it just a little bit and putting it in there. A little deep, but not all the way through. Maybe about 3/4 of the way through the cube. And there you have it. There's the first clone, and hopefully it will take. Now here's a bigger one, and I can probably get a couple of clones off of this. If you look, there is the V in there, and there's a couple nodes on the one branch, and there's even a couple on the other one. So I think I can get 2 out of this guy, and that should help us out a little bit. So I'll just clean this up. That's one cutting. Take off this leaf. And I'll cut this one at a 45, right about here. I could probably take off some of these larger leaves too if I really wanted to, or even cut them down, just because they don't need to be that big. They'll probably dry out the plant a little bit quicker. And these I will try to clone as well. This time, why don't we try the gel? Alright, got a few more here to go. Small one looks pretty good. There is a flower on it, so I don't know if that'll be a problem in the future, but I'll just take it off. And same thing, I'm going to put a 45 in this one. And this one, I will use the gel as well. Actually, you know what? Why don't I double dip this one? And this one I'm actually going to try in some soil. So I got just a basic soil mix here. And I'll put a hole in there with a pencil. And I'll put this cutting in here. Just pat around it a bit. And that one is done and ready to go also. So last one here, I'll clean this up. I might leave that as is. Take off some of the bottom here. I've seen people also scrape alongside the bottom of the plant too, where they want it to take. But I think just the cut in there and then the rooting hormone, you should be all right. So with this one, I'll do again. Whatever. Put a little bit of both on there, and I will put that in another soil pot here. And maybe just to stop it from drying out, I'll cut down some of these leaves here too. see if that does anything. And that is pretty much it. So I'm going to put these guys in the humidity dome and keep an eye on them. Hopefully in about a week and a half, 2 weeks, we'll see some roots coming through the bottom, and we'll know these things have took, and we'll know that they are their own plants now. So let's get those over there. So that's pretty much it. That's the way I do it. Then again, you know, like I've only done it successfully twice before, but we'll see how this round goes. If you don't have a humidity dome, you're not out of luck. You can use like a mister or something to just keep things really nice and humid. And you want to hit that up as much as you can throughout the day. Once you get some roots on there, you can crack the vents, or you don't have to spray them as much. And you can go ahead, put them into your hydroponic system or your soil garden, whatever you have there. So if you guys do cloning differently, or you've seen something that might not be correct here, make sure you leave a comment below. And thanks for watching, and hope this was helpful.